Y2 News this morning. Speaking of the South, they are getting hit with a storm today, and then, you know, Southwest, they are getting hit with hot temperatures. So I'm feeling pretty lucky being in Boise right now.
Yeah, as hot as it was yesterday, I think it's nice you kind of see what is going on around the country. Some extreme weather, very different threats from the Southeast to the Southwest, but yeah. You don't want to be caught in either situation if you can at all avoid it. So we'll start there. I wanted to give you a look at some of the highs we saw yesterday down in the Southwest. We kind of don't typically focus on yesterday, but a lot of record temperatures being broken there. Phoenix breaking their record for that day, not quite breaking their all-time record, but 119. In Ocotillo Wells in San Diego County, the hottest temperature ever recorded there, 124 degrees. Las Vegas hit 117, tying their all-time high temperature record. Death Valley 127 yesterday, and we did hit 120 in Yuma, Arizona. More of that heat is on the way today, already warming up. We're in the 90s, if not triple digits already in a lot of these areas, but we're going to see 115 in Vegas, 118 in Phoenix. So can't even really say you're cooling down, because at that point, that heat is so dangerous and excessive. It doesn't really matter if you're a couple degrees off. We're triple digits in Salt Lake today too. We're on the northern edge of this, and we got that cold front that came through cooling us off a little bit today. So more comfortable daytime highs for us, but down in the Southwest, we have heat advisories posted and excessive heat warnings spread across parts of Arizona, California, Nevada, and up into southern Utah. So another toasty, extremely dangerously hot day over there in the Southwest. And then again, as we head to the Southeast, the Central Gulf Coast getting pounded with very heavy rain this morning, courtesy of Tropical Storm Cindy. With this rain, we could see 6 to 9 inches in some spots, up to 12 inches of rain in the heaviest hit spots. So the main threat with this storm is going to be rain. Cindy is a slow mover, wanting to move along very slowly, so we'll dump rain even though the wind speeds won't be as high. But in addition, we also have tornado warnings spread here along parts of Louisiana, southern Mississippi, and Alabama. Flash flood watches and a tropical storm warning. So a busy situation out there in the Southeast. Going to be a dangerous day, and you can see the projected track of this storm continues to barrel through the United States, but it is expected to weaken as it comes inland. So good news there, hopefully going to be one piece of good news around here. Boy, completely different story. Good morning to you here in Idaho. Certainly feeling a lot nicer. 60s in the lower valleys. We're at 40s and 50s in the mountains, so a more comfortable feel out there early on. 62 in Meridian and Nampa. Caldwell, good morning to you. It's also 62. Our daytime highs should reach into the upper 80s, but we'll back off from the 90s for a few degrees. So nice to see the sunshine sticking around with more comfortable temperatures. Winds will be a little bit of a factor, I think, in the afternoon, but our daytime highs are still going to be warm enough that it might just feel like a nice summer breeze. 89 in Mountain Home today. Caldwell, 88. 70s and 80s in the mountains. I think as we head into the afternoon, early evening, we could see those winds gusting up to 30 miles an hour, mostly east of Boise, but Boise eastward included in that down south toward Mountain Home. It'll be coming out of the northwest, but we're kind of going to see wind sustained in that 10 to 20 mile an hour range. Repeating this for tomorrow, so more wind on the way, but again, kind of that 15 to 25 mile an hour range, strongest gusts south and east of Boise, and then winds will dissipate, die down as we head into Friday. Hey, if you're headed out to the Hawks game tonight, a live after 5, plenty going on. Temps going to be in the 80s. Sunshine with a little bit of a breeze should feel pretty comfortable out there, though. We'll stick with the 80s all the way through 9 o'clock by the end of the Hawks game. Hopefully those temperatures dipping into the upper 70s. So it should be another warm one, but much more bearable than yesterday. Into that extended forecast, we stick with the 80s for the next few days. Winds will be around for us today and tomorrow, but then by Friday, I think we'll see lighter wind speeds, so it might actually start to feel a little bit warmer as we budge into the weekend. We hit 90 by Sunday and then jump up into the upper 90s Monday. Still haven't had our first triple-digit day on the map yet, but Monday looking pretty close. Could also throw in a stray heat-fueled thunderstorm. We are going to be watching Monday for the chance of thunderstorms and then cooling off just a